Hey everyone, I wanted to talk to you about creating well-written discussion board posts. You will be writing discussion posts throughout the semester, and there are certain elements that are expected. If you go to the modules page in Canvas and scroll down to module 1, you'll see two pages here, how discussion boards are graded, and a well-written discussion board post. Let's look at this example. And it notes elements here that we need to remember to include. First of all, it's important to introduce the author by full name first, before referring to him or her by last name only. You can see here in the example, the writer has introduced the author by his entire full name, as well as the title of the story the discussion board post is about. Later, the writer does refer to the author by last name only, but this is appropriate because that first formal introduction has been made. Next, you want to make sure that you're referencing the text, and this means including quotations from the text. You can see this writer has included a quote right here that is properly framed by her own words. That's something you want to make sure to do as well, is frame your quotations. And the formula for properly framing a quotation is to clearly introduce the idea of the quote first, state the quote, and then make a statement that explains how the quote relates to your ideas and the topic of the paragraph. If you were to leave a quote here at the end with no explanation afterward, that would be called a dangling quote. You don't want to do that. You always want to have your own words framing and explaining the quotation, showing readers why it is there in your work and how it works with your ideas. You also want to have proper in-text citation. And there are some videos here in the module that will help you with that if you have any questions. But you want to include that citation after each quotation, directly after. You note also this punctuation surrounding citation. When you have a quote followed by a citation, the period, you can notice, does not go after the end of the sentence and inside the quotation mark like it normally would. When there's a citation afterwards, it comes after the citation. And that's something I'll be checking as well. Let's go here to the discussion board itself. And I'm going to show you a little checklist that is on each board. So if you go to the bottom of any discussion board, you're going to see this checklist asking you if you wrote a minimum of 300 words. Did you introduce the author by his or her full name first before referring to him or her only by last name? Did you address all of the questions asked? Did you include quotes from the text and did you frame them? Did you use in-text citation and did you format it correctly? Did you use respectful language and a formal academic tone? And did you check your spelling, grammar, and punctuation? Also, you have to remember to respond to two of your peers. If you ever need to look at the model example, there's a link on the page as well as the page of how discussion boards are graded. But another way to find out how they're graded is to look at the rubric. And to find it on a discussion board, you're going to click on these three vertical dots and select Show Rubric. So here is the actual rubric that I use for grading. You can see again, it grades for minimum word count, for including quotes, for in-text citation, for framing and integrating the quotes well, for your punctuation and grammar, your language, addressing all the questions thoroughly, the author reference, punctuation, and peer response. So quite a few elements go into this, and if you just tick off that list and include all those elements, you can get the full 40 points for your discussion post. So if you have any questions, please ask me, and I hope this helps.